Julie with Centennial Canoe Outfitters. Now let's talk about the things that you're going to want to have readily accessible with you while you're in your boat. I recommend bringing along a simple backpack, a day backpack. And because this isn't waterproof, anything that you put in here that you want to keep dry should go into a Ziploc bag just to keep it dry. One of the most important things that you're going to want to have with you is a water bottle. And I specifically like this one because it has a loop that I can easily hook into my boat and secure it. I also recommend something that has a fair enough quantity. This one's 32 ounces. We recommend at least 24 ounce bottle. And a wide mouth helps because you will be having to refill this bottle from our water jugs. If you're thinking about bringing the grocery store disposable water bottles, I don't recommend that, primarily because the top is so tiny it's really hard to refill. Centennial Canoe is going to be giving you a mug at the first breakfast. You're going to want to keep this in your day backpack because you're going to want it at lunchtime so you can drink the lemonade and fruit juices that we serve. I specifically carry a camelback when I'm on the river. I like it because I can secure it in the boat and I can just reach over and suck on the water whenever I'm thirsty. Rain gear is very important. And these garments, both rain pants and a rain jacket, should be waterproof, not just water resistant. If you don't have any good rain gear already, you can buy some more inexpensive stuff at probably stores like Target or Walmart, and that will do in a pinch. What I like to do with these bulkier items is I will go ahead and roll them up and secure them with a rubber band to keep them compressed, and then I will put them in a Ziploc bag to keep them dry, and these items then will go into my day backpack. And I do recommend the press and seal Ziploc bags. Cameras. I have personally invested in a small dry bag for my camera. If you don't have one of these, just double bag it with Ziploc bags and that will suffice. Sunglasses are a must, and secure straps to keep them from falling in the river. Bring along some good sunscreen, and plenty of it, because you should be reapplying throughout the day. This one is an SPF of 50. And along with that, you want some good lip balm. Hand protection. If you tend to get calluses or you've got very delicate hands, you could bring some biking gloves or weightlifting gloves to wear while you paddle. I personally have some rubberized gloves that I wear when the temperature is colder. You don't need to go out and buy anything like this. Just some simple rubber dishwashing gloves will suffice. I also have invested in some, these are called seal socks, seal skin, which will keep my feet dry if the weather is colder. Again, you don't need to go out and buy these, just some wool socks will help keep your feet dry, or feet warm, I should say. I always bring along a bag of granola bars or some nuts, so even though Centennial does provide snacks throughout the day, if my boat is way in the back and the guy that's got all the snacks is up front and I'm not going to get to him very quickly, then I've got something readily accessible. A little trick of the trade that I have found is I bring a piece of a chamois cloth, and once this is wet, it cleans my eyeglasses very easily. I tend to get in a lot of water fights and I end up with speckled eyeglasses all the time. I have my bug spray, I have chapstick, I have some hand sanitizer, I have a pocket knife, and some aspirin. And again, all of these items will go in your day backpack and will secure that in your boat. And you should be ready.